Thank you guys for checking out this stream. Had some technical difficulties, but we are live. Tonight, we will hear from two DMB fans that went to the Oslo, Norway show. And is this the best DMB European tour stop so far? Stay tuned. The DMB post-show stream starts now.
Yeah.
It's your boy Concert Viz 34 back at home.
What up, what up? It's your boy Concert Viz 34.
Yep, so your boy Concert Viz 34 coming to you here.
What up, what up? It's your boy Concert Viz 34. Thank you. Aria. Okay, so this is Aria. And just tell us a little bit about yourself and about your love for the Dave Matthews Band.
I've been a fan of the band since April 28, 1998. And if you recognize the date, that's when Before These Crowded Streets was released.
Alpine is definitely a better venue than Summerfest, but we'll take it. I think I've been going to shows for about 20-something years.
I always tell people, like, compare DMB to now to when I first started. And I got started, in my opinion, I feel like I got started late. Like, I was at the very end of the band's prime. I feel like that 03 to 06 was, like, the end of the prime. 07, 08 was, like, you know, we're at the very end. And then when Roy passed.
Dave really, this is the thing. Dave has put, Rashawn has been assigned the quarterback of this team. He is the coach, the play caller. He designs the jams. Dave just shows up and plays whatever he's going to play.
Oslo, what up? Shout out to the Nobel Peace Prize winners. Welcome to Europe, two step. Welcome to Europe, 41. Welcome to Europe, typical situation. And for the first time, the only thing played in Europe, what up? Shout out UConn men's basketball going to the ship. Shout out women's basketball breaking all-time ratings this weekend. Caitlin Clark, Paige Becker, Dawn Staley. What up, it's your boy Concert Viz 34, and thank you guys for your patience. Want to roll real quick, just a special meeting of family, but I'll be back for the Wednesday stream back at the crib. Just a quick turnaround here. Thank you guys for tuning into the DMB post show stream. Now, full disclosure, because I was with loved ones celebrating family today, I did not watch the stream live. But when I'm telling you, man, the most important thing you can have is special time spent with loved ones, including part of that at a watching the NCAA tournament. There is no replacement for that. As much as I love D&B, I will always put family first, respectfully. And you should do the same. But this show, I'm going to be sharing a video from Kumi. I'm going to be reading off remarks from Aria. And they're going to be able to give you just reaction being there. Aria's first European show of this tour. She was in South Africa as well. She has traveled across many places to see DMB when she can. And Kumi, again, is doing a Euro trip, has some friends and buddies with him, and is in loving what he sees. But what I can say is this band is giving everything to Europe. And Europe appears to be giving everything to this band. All of these tour debuts are impressive. It doesn't matter, like, you know, you have your favorite songs, I have my favorite songs. And yes, this is a European tour, it's not the full-scale tour, and you're going to have debuts. But for this band to provide so many different portions of their catalog, this is special. Forget what you want to hear, what's your favorite, what the perfect show. They are giving Europe everything. And I'll listen back to the Couch Tour and really get to dissect this a little further in the next, when I get, you know, probably tomorrow when I'm reset and can do more to listen to this. But this is, I mean, Europe isn't asking for the variety we get in America. They're just asking to see this band, and the band is not only giving them the bare minimum of playing new music, playing classics. They had literally, you could go to all of these shows and you're getting so much music. And I think we need to appreciate that and celebrate that. And these fans are loved by the band. Jeff Coffin has been sending messages, subliminal and direct, about these fans and how they behave. And you know what? I agree with Jeff Coffin. In America, we can be horrible fans at shows. We can be horrible. The activities and behavior that we see, the blatant talking during shows while the band is playing. If you can't see it, if you can't see the subliminals, I'm telling you straight up, DMB is saying, listen, American fans, y'all need to chill. And even as you come into Europe, be respectful, right? And we're seeing these fans, you're going to hear some of Aria's remarks, I'll read those off. And it's gonna echo that as far as what she took from this as an American traveling over there. But everything that I'm hearing from fans in Europe, hey, this is how they do. And these people I'm talking to, they're saying, all right, I'm going to really be respectful of these European fans, which is how we all should be when we go into these different countries, whether it's for music or for other things. We have to respect the local rules, regulations, and culture of how they take in a soccer match or football match, which is even different than how we do it, right? So let me go ahead. I want to get straight to the interview that, essentially what this is, I could not talk to Kumi. He sent me a video. This is going to be a video directly from Kumi. I want you guys to listen in to him. And here is Kumi DMB.
What's up? It's Kumi DMB, also known as DMB Fan JTR. I am recording this video for Concert Vids 34 live stream for the April 7th, 2024 DMB show in Oslo, Norway. I went to the show tonight. I went with one of my buddies who is a casual fan at best. This was his second show. His first show was Night 2 of the Gorge with me in September. He was excited to hear Crash. And he also really likes When the World Ends. So that was a nice opener that we got there. The venue was really cool. It was a lot bigger than the first two stops of the tour that I went to. The first two stops of the Europe tour. I think the seating was between 12 and 15,000. I've seen a couple of different things, so I'm not sure exactly what the number is, but it's definitely a lot more than the first two venues, Amsterdam, Cologne, and Hanover as well, I think. Yeah, we got there only 15 minutes before doors opened. The line was long. The line was really long. People were ready to come see DMB play, and there was a big mix of people. I mean, I saw a lot of European people. My buddy, who is Norwegian, said there was a bunch of American people, but I guess I noticed the Europeans more, especially around me. We were in the pit about six rows back at the beginning. At some point, he went to the bathroom, and he couldn't make his way back, so we switched to a portion kind of left of stage, left of even Buddy. And our beginning spot, we were in that spot from, you know, the beginning of the show when we got there till about, so much to say, about nine songs in. And then I went back there to the left and ended up staying over there. It was an interesting view point from that angle. The middle of the pit was packed, but the outside, the pit was so deep. It was so wide and so deep. There was a lot of space on the sides especially, but the middle was all packed. But we ended up being on the side, and it was pretty, we had enough room to move around and stuff. The acoustics were pretty good. It was a bigger venue, so I think they were kind of equipped to deal with, you know, louder sounds. It did take some time for the sound to get where the band wanted it to be. During Madman's, Dave was gesturing a lot, because honestly, Madman's usually packs a punch, but it was a little bit more quiet than I remember it being today. But I think they fixed it by the end of the song. It sounded normal. So the acoustics were a little bit a work in progress at the beginning, but I think they ended up being fine about halfway through the set. High points of the set, you know, obviously, I think the people got really excited for 41. I mean, that's, you know, it was the anniversary of that song, and people were pumped about that early on in the set. Let me see what else they were looking at. Looking at the set right now as well. Yeah, I mean, people loved Crash. I mean, obviously, Crash is the most popular song DMB has, arguably. People were excited about that. People were excited about Watchtower. You know, we're in Europe, and they had the Stairway Interpolation. I mean, obviously, people got super pumped about that song, and obviously Two Step is a banger. Everyone loves Two Step. If you're a casual DMB fan or a new fan or a longtime fan, I think everyone kind of, Two Step's pretty well liked. So I guess it would be loud. I thought it was the loudest around Crash, honestly. My favorite part, it's hard to argue against the Two Step that was played so well, and it was a tour debut, right? We had seven tour debuts today, which is awesome to see. You know, four stops into Europe, seven tour debuts, not bad. So I really liked hearing Lying in the Hands of God, though. The ABI interpolation at the end is always one of my favorites, so that was really cool. So if not Two Step, I think Lying in the Hands of God wins it for me. Typical Situation also sounded great tonight. That was a really good version of the song. You Might Die Trying was good. The Only Thing sounded good, too. Say Goodbye is always nice to hear. So good set overall. I really enjoyed it. It was nice to be out there. Nice to bring my buddy with me as well. And I think, you know, the venue was pretty packed for a Sunday night show in Oslo. I mean, all through the, obviously there's a big pit, like I said, but there was also seating right behind the pit, and there's like another level up there. I think Marcus might show you all a video that I sent him of the venue, but it was generally packed all the way up in the back. The sides were just kind of empty on the pit and the seating as well. But I did notice, I looked around a bit, because I read some things about, not at this venue, but somebody posted on Facebook, one of the groups, about how Europeans don't want you to stand at all if you have a seat. And I did look around to see if that was the case. It looked like a lot of people were sitting. It looked like everybody was sitting if they had seats. They were not, no one was standing in those sections. So I have a seat tomorrow in Stockholm. We'll see if I keep that going. I will have a hard time sitting still, probably, especially if they play some crazy stuff because it's two back-to-back shows. I'm sure they're gonna have something cool tomorrow as well. But yeah, that was interesting to see. Everyone was sitting pretty much the whole show. Every time I looked back there, people were sitting. What else have I not covered? The poster. One cool thing about this venue, I thought it was cool. People might not think it was cool, but when you buy a poster, they already had the posters inside the tubes. So they just hand you a tube already in there. You don't have to worry about, you know, wrapping it up and putting it in there. Save you some time to get to the pit or wherever you're going, you know. So that was cool. The poster, it wasn't my favorite. It wasn't my least favorite. I did find out it's a methane, which is pretty funny. People are very, you know, methane is pretty divisive. People hate it. People love it. It's based in my hometown, so I try to give it as much love as I can. But I mean, this wasn't my favorite poster. It was a cool poster. I got it. But on a 1 to 10 scale, it's probably like a 5.5 or 6. It's not like one of my favorites, but it's gonna go up on the wall somewhere. We'll find a spot for it. But yeah, I think the crowd also, just to add one thing I wanted to guess add before I go, is the crowd was pretty mixed. It wasn't as quiet as some points. It was just as quiet as it has been in Amsterdam and at Cologne. But I definitely heard a lot more chatter today. Maybe it's because the area I was standing in the second half of the show, maybe I was in an area where talking was more acceptable. But there's definitely a lot of chatter, more than I'm used to. But the band, again, Dave did mention how he likes that European crowds are quiet and so attentive. And the beginning of the show was very quiet. And when I was up in the, you know, in the middle of the pit, When the world ends was completely quiet. Like, there was no talking at all for the opener song. So, yeah, that's my thoughts on the Oslo show tonight. Another great one. And thanks again, Marcus, for having me on your stream. I will talk to you tomorrow for Stockholm if you want to have me on.
So that was Kumi DMB. And let me show you the video of what he took before the show. And I appreciate him. This is what the crowd looked like. Now, again, this was well before the show started. So you do see some empty seats here. This was just like he got in with the people that were looking to get some nice pit seats. I love the elevation on this. I wonder how it would be. If you guys don't know already, I love having elevation to being able to see over the people in front of you. And this looks like this venue did have it there. So I want to thank Kumi for sharing that. We will get back to Twitter in just a moment. We're going to talk about what Tyler Hensley had as far as a very cool subject. What I'm actually going to do, and I'll bring it up in a sec, I'll tell you. We're going to take a question. Yeah, you're going to be able to pick some songs you want to hear at every DMB show. And I'm going to actually make an intro video of all as many answers as possible. And I'll try to place them in there that way. And shout out to Goose. They are having their first show with Cotter on drums. If you're coming in from the Goose intermission, hope you guys are enjoying those shows, streaming them for free on YouTube as the band kind of builds up their reps live in front of an audience with their new drummer. So this show right here that you see, this is the Cameron Indoor Stadium show, April 7th, 1995. So that's 29 years ago. Today, 41 debuted as 41 Police. The lyrics are different. It is an early, obviously, version. It was still in progress. And they played a number 40, 41 Watchtower Closer. So that's what he was alluding to in that interview when he talked about the anniversary of 41 being played for the first time. So what I want to do next is we're going to look at Aria and what she had to say. She wrote out some stuff. It was the most efficient way for me to get her detailed review there and kind of summed up her thoughts So we're going to go ahead and take a look at some of these things here. So this is it's two slides here that you're going to see. And let's go to the first one. All right. So this is what it says. Lining up early was the same for U.S. shows. There were even some new regions in line early, too. We asked security if we seemed crazy lining up 5 hours before doors open. The security guard said that there were fans for another band. She can't remember the name of that band, but it was a recognizable name that camped out near the venue 3 days before the show. So this is something they've experienced with other acts, even on a higher level. The venue was intimate, smaller than typical arenas. And that's from DMB. She is fan Aria, who's been on the stream. She's on the intro. You hear her voice there. A great friend that I've made and hung out with at various DMB shows and talked to behind the scenes about DMB things. All right. So the next one is part two. She's going to talk a little bit more about that. So she also said the merch booth. Now, these photos, by the way, are from Kumi. These are Kumi DMB photos, just to let you know. These were not taken by Aria, but they did match what Aria was saying. The merch booth and bar were very accessible. The Norwegian fans enjoyed the show. For the ones I spoke to, they hadn't seen DMB in over 25 years. Favorite moment of the show, Dave talking about Stefan dropping out of high school and college. She says important things fans should know. It's the same at every show. Enjoy the music, have fun, and stop having super loud conversations during songs. And she also said, if you're going to talk real, real quietly, just for YouTube, the algorithm, that's how we're going to say it. But she did add that into her thoughts as well. So Stefan did drop out of high school and college to tour with Dave Matthews Band. I would say he made the right decision. Because obviously it worked out to where he didn't need to be a doctor, lawyer, whatever he wanted to be. Being part of DMB is what he was meant to do. And I'm always an advocate for the bass being in the mix. Band's hard to mix because there's so many instruments, but I love Stefan's bass shining and I love him having the space to play there. But Great insight from both of our fans. Aria's first show. Think that's interesting that some fans hadn't seen this band for 25 years. Boy, have they changed in so many ways. So this is a set. If we go back to the set list, this is a great set to kind of catch them up on what's new and give them a little bit of what's old. We also get the first Away From The World song of the tour in Rooftop. Welcome to the show. And if we go to the summary, and shout out to the DMB Almanac, we can see we got Away From The World, Remember Two Things, Stand Up, Busted Stuff Every Day, Some Devil, Before These Crowded Streets, Come Tomorrow, Big Whiskey, Under The Table Dreaming, Walk Around The Moon, and Crash. All with songs played there, and then you got some various covers and some other associated things. And so this is great. I mean, again, 58 songs there. What I want to do before we wrap up, again, this will be brief. I do want to also look at a question that Tyler has. You guys are so awesome. The Twitter, DMB Twitter is awesome. I know you guys may have feel a way about Twitter. It can get very intense. There can be arguments about a lot of things, especially sports and politics, it seems. But I'll tell you this, DMB Twitter, there's some great things that go on in DMB Twitter. And one of them, Tyler, we showed you Bihar, who has some great insight. Gives us a lot of insight on posters and different unique songs that may be played. And I know Tyler's enjoying Goose right now. He's probably not watching this stream, but he did have a great question And we're going to look at that question right now. And then you guys can answer this question. Hit the like button. Put it in the chat of this video. And what I'm going to do is make a video using some sort of audio from some sort of tape or audio or audio from DMB's catalog. And I'm going to then mix in your people will be able to see what you said, right? As long as it's on a public, what I'm going to do is going to be stuff from Twitter and from this YouTube video. I will not pull anything from a message board or forum, just to respect the guidelines of those forums and message boards, which are set to private. But we do have this idea. What are five songs? And let me, what I'm going to do here is slide myself down so you guys can see it. But what are five DMB songs you could hear at every show and never get tired of? Let's see if right there. You guys can see that, I'm sure. What are five DMB songs you could hear every show and never get tired of? Your opinion matters. Don't try to say, oh, I know Concert Viz doesn't like Bayou or this, that. Now, I want to hear what you guys want to say, and we're going to post them up. And I think it'll also showcase how this catalog is dissected by fans in different ways, which is okay. But I want you guys to participate. I want you guys to share your thoughts, and we'll go from there. I have a show tomorrow. And again, if you know anyone who wants to be on, wants to share some thoughts and opinions, please have them message me. That's the best way to message me: Instagram, Twitter, Facebook. Rach, I see you in the chat. Like I said, message me if you can. I'll take a look after this stream. Instagram, Twitter, Facebook are the best ways. ConcertViz34 and all of those. My Facebook page is fairly new. And not as followed, which is expected. But if you are on Facebook, definitely follow me there. And there's sometimes some sneak previews. I'm actually going to close out this show with the video that was premiered on Facebook first. Before it was part of the MSG Night 2 multicam, you got it on Facebook first. And there'll be some other stuff that comes on Facebook first, just so you guys can engage over on that end. And thank you guys for the support. Thank you guys for the feedback. What do you want from this show? What do you like? What do you don't like? I appreciate feedback. I appreciate just your thoughts. It seems like a lot of people, y'all like this new stream setup. And even if it's negative, positive, whatever you have, whatever you think, I may listen to it. I may not. But I want to make this for the fans, and I want to pull away from this being about me personally. You're going to get some of my insight here and there, especially the shows I go to. But I think this is a great way to showcase how there are different ways people take in shows. There are different things people like and don't like, or they may like everything this band does. And I want to showcase this on the post-show stream. So continue to do that. Alex says he misses all the air horns and all that stuff. Okay. Well, we'll see. Maybe we can bring that back. Bring that beat back, right? for you guys that way. So stay tuned. And tomorrow, my UConn Huskies are playing Purdue. And I respect Purdue. Actually, I've seen them. Funny thing, I've seen UConn men's basketball once in the NCAA tournament, the Elite Eight game in 2014. I've seen Purdue twice, almost not on purpose, but just by chance. I was at the Kansas City Sweet 16 / Elite Eight in 2017, which was an awesome experience. That was through business, through work. I happened to be there. And I was rooting for Purdue to beat Kansas. They lost to Kansas. Now, Kansas was 35 minutes from the Sprint Center. Now it's the T-Mobile Center. And so they had a huge home field advantage, and they had a talented team, but Purdue gave them a great fight. Also saw the Carson Edwards Purdue Boilermakers in Hartford at the XL Center for the first and second round tournament. games in Hartford, which were awesome. We sold that joint to capacity, I think, for nearly all the sessions, if not all of them. It was a great experience. And so we'll face Tyler Eady. I'll tell you this, man, like, as you see, my profile picture is me wearing a Ray Allen 34 shirt. I love UConn basketball. This has been so much fun watching this team, and I can't even explain it. I mean, they lost key players, and they still have found a way to be even more dominant, but Purdue's going to be no joke. Again, I respect them. And so we're going to have to bring our A game and be consistent. We can't just live off the laurels of the last games that we've played in this tournament and even last tournament. Got to work hard. So anyway, without further ado, here is the last stop. Oh, sorry, Spoon, not the last stop. Solid change. This was a Facebook exclusive. And I hope you guys enjoy it. Shout out Into the Vacuum. He got the pitch shots for us.
as I walk, his voice is behind me. Sing, sinner, sin, come out and pay.
What up, it's your boy ContraViz34.